Okay, this time let's think of a turret. Turret is a kind of banded. You can think of a turret as a banded cylinder in the shape of a circle. Okay, so let's think of this turret, and we're just doing this winding of a wire on the surface of the turret. Okay, it's a donut shape. And well, always you can just decide the number of turns per unit length along the circle axis of the turret. This is the circular axis of the turret. So turret is kind of take a solenoid and bend it like in the shape of a circle. That's it. By using only one wire, of course, you can just wind up this wire through the surface of the turret. And you can make a winding like this. And again, just like a solenoid, a toroid is also used for creating a magnetic field inside it, inside the toroid. And thinking that right at the center of the toroid, we have the magnetic field B, and it is the same everywhere on this central circle that crosses through the geometrical center of the toroid, like this. If you want to find the magnetic field, then you can just apply again Ampere's law. And I'm not going to go to detail. In details are already given in the case of finding this, applying this Ampere's law for a case of solenoid. So this B dot ds along this certain circle, the geometrical central circle for the toroid. Okay, if you take this circle's radiuses to be small r. Well, small r is going to be just the midway between this B radius and the C radius. B radius is just from measured from the center this distance to the wire winding, and C is this outside distances, and just r is just midway between B and C. That's it. So, well, of course, this r is can be always measurable. It's going to be size of the toroid anyway. So by using Ampere's law, it's very easy to find that the magnetic field strength right at this central circle, geometrical center, central circle on inside the toroid, is going to be mu zero times n times I. N is the number of turns, total number of turns. N is the total number of turns on the solenoid because toroid is a finite solenoid. Solenoid can be infinitely long, but since a toroid is finite, it's going to having the certain finite number of n turns. If you know this number of turns, and this is going to be mu zero n, mu zero times n times I divided by 2 pi small r. As I said, this small r is nothing but the central radius of the central circle of the toroid. So the result is mu zero times n times I divided by 2 pi small r.